I flew down there from Philly to come to New Orleans because I used to pray for times like this to rhyme like this, so I had to rhyme like that and shine like this. You heard me? Y'all laugh, but listen to the words. Listen to the words. Because right now, each one of y'all be up in the school every day. Y'all see people in your life you don't want to be like. Everybody got a reason why they not making it. What will be your reason for not making it? Or will you have a reason to make it? Will it be your little brother, your little sister? Will it be your mother that you want to help out one day? Will it be for you? Because bottom line is this, nobody wakes up in the morning and say they want to be homeless. But we got homeless people. Nobody wants to wake up and say they got to struggle day after day after day. But people do it. Now is the time, now is the place for y'all to understand this. The one thing that's going to change your life, that's going to elevate you, and I heard it before back in the day, like, yo, school, all of that, yeah, yeah. This is the thing that will take you to another level in life, yo. Real rap. My name is Marion Wilson. I'm from North Philly, and this is Rap Academics.
Five seconds, 2 seconds, 3 seconds.
30 seconds. Tell me this, right here, one mic. What happens if you run a stop sign? You can crash, you can go to jail, you can get a ticket. Sometimes nothing happens, right? You can die. Real rap. Check this out, one mic. Stop, so when you see that stop sign means this. Stop, think, observe, and then proceed. Now, I'm gonna show y'all something. In y'all life, y'all gonna be this age for a little bit of time. Everybody in this room was your age once. Your parents were your age once. Your auntie was your age once. Your big brother was your age once. And guess what? We all got older. What that means is this, you're gonna be older longer than you're gonna be younger. And all of these people that constantly talk to you, try to give you game, positive affirmations, they say you can do it and all of that, right? They nothing but a stop sign. This is 30 seconds of your life, little brothers and sisters, because y'all won't be here long. And when you get to high school, when you get to the 12th grade, when you graduate from school, all of this will be but a memory. But some things that some people say to you the same way they hurt you, you remember forever. Gotta hold on to some of them good things too, because it's like a stop sign. And if you don't listen, guess what can happen? The same thing that happened if you don't go through a stop sign, when you go through a stop sign. Somebody try to tell you, hey, don't go up there and mess with the boys, you go up there anyway. Boom, you a dead jail. He tried to warn you, but you ran the stop sign. Boom, you stop, you listen, you wait, you proceed. So when I look at a stop sign, I use this as this method, right? When somebody's talking to you, like I'm talking to you now, because I had a hard time learning. I wasn't the smartest. I never got straight A's. I never got straight B's. Real rap. But guess what happens? Now I have people who work for me, who got straight A's, who got all B's, but I'm their boss. Real rap. And understand this, when somebody's talking to you, you need to stop. When I say stop, stop thinking. Stop thinking about what you're gonna do later. Stop thinking about what's happening with your friends. As people are talking to you, think about what they're saying to you. All right, he's saying this, she's saying this, all right. But then also observe their body language. How they talking to you? They like this, they all animated. How are they talking to you? What's their body language like? Do you feel like as they're talking to you, they really like are good for you, they mean well for you? After you stop thinking, observe, now you can do this. You can proceed. That means you can move. And see, the only reason why I'm here in front of y'all is because I listened. I stopped, I think, I observed, and now I proceed, which I can take a flight earlier this morning, be here today, I'm going in a couple of hours. You gotta learn how to stop, y'all. Now check. I just told y'all that these people in your life are stop signs, right? Tell me this. On a football field, where do the coach stand?
On the sideline.
On the basketball, where the coach stand?
On the sideline.
On the sideline, right? Check this out. All coaches are on the sideline. Your parents are on the sideline. The people who care about you are on the sideline. Your teachers are on the sideline. Y'all are the star of y'all game. And y'all gonna make it or break it, because I done read a whole lot of things about Angola. Angola is the largest prison in the United States. Got more black women and men locked up in Angola. Angola is a country in Africa that's ran by who? Black people. But then guess what they did? They turned it over and turned it into a prison here in Louisiana. You are not slaves, y'all. Y'all are not born to be prisoners, y'all. But guess what? The coaches can only do one thing. Scream from the sideline. Only thing we can do is this.
Can you be strong for 15 minutes? Can you? Yeah. Listen, your concentration's weaving a little bit. Pick it up. Pick it up! Go pull straight out. Bend your knees to be strong on the inside, go around it. Let's control the outside. Look, the fire's coming. Are you ready for the fire? Look, we're firemen. Okay. We are firemen! The heat doesn't bother us. We live in the heat. We train in the heat.
Yeah, let's go.
It tells us that we're ready, we're at home. We're where we're supposed to be. Flames don't intimidate us. What do? We control the plane. We control them. We move the plane where we want to. And then we extinguish them.
All of you, only thing we can do in your life is motivate y'all. But you gotta fight the fight. You gotta make the choice not to hang with those people because your five closest friends are who you are. So if your five closest friends can't read, you illiterate. If your five closest friends smoke weed, you a pothead. If your five closest friends are stealing, you a thief. If your five closest friends are trying to get to this education, you're an intellect. If you want to change your life, you need to start looking at who you really hanging around. Because some of y'all got friends just because you know how to rumble and she don't got no hands. Some of y'all hanging around these guys because he get the girls and you don't. So you need to grow up. So you really need to start watching the people you're around you. This is another jewel. Why? Start asking yourself these questions, because when you get older, it can save you a lot of heartache and pain. Why are they hanging around me? Why are they hanging around me? What value do they bring to my life? Since I've been hanging with you, have I gotten in more trouble? Since I've been hanging with you, have I been doing better in my classes? You need to start looking at your friends, because bottom line is this. When I go to the prisons to see all the young guys who I bang with, my youngins, and I see them doing life, one of my best friends, 16 years old, murdered somebody, life at 16. And the only thing they tell me, every time I go to the prisons to see my youngins, you know what they say? Hey, and it was me and my friends. Me and my friends. Now your friends dropping statements on him. You ain't even know he can read, but he done wrote a whole dictionary about what y'all did. That's real life. Watch who you hanging around. Why they hanging around you? What value do they bring to your life?